Always, yeah. It went against right now.
She's coming.
Here she comes. Whoa.
During the night, he woke up and called me. I heard his voice call my name. I don't know what he did. I mean, if the papers say he robbed a bank, does that mean he did? He made me feel that I could trust.
This is Checkpoint Morris Avenue. Suspect Karl heading west on Pearl Drive towards 16th.
We copy. DiCarlo will pick him up on Bentwood and follow undercover. 10 more.
Through for the day.
Oh, Kath, it's gonna be a great party. Come on. Get here late.
I have to, but listen, Kath, I want you to come now. And bring people. For God's sakes, invite anybody.
I wish you knew some men. Do you know someone who knows men?
I don't know, Janet. I think you better give up on me. I've been working since 6 o'clock this morning.
Please.
Come on.
Distance. Give him plenty of room. If he thinks he's being tailed, it's all over.
Don't worry.
I want another mobile surveillance car, and I want a state backup force on alert in case we get lucky.
10-4. Just keep us posted of your location, DiCarlo.
If he does link up with some of the others, will we have enough men to cover them all?
We'll have to.
Wouldn't it be something if they picked this town to hole up in and our boys nailed him?
Watch it, he's turning.
Great headline, huh? Small town police force captures entire Weatherman gang. Wouldn't that be something?
We really need a bigger truck.
We really need another cook. We're doing parties for 60 or 70 people a week now.
We can't afford another cook. We're barely breaking even. Oh, look at these tomatoes.
Kath, don't chop.
Aren't they beautiful? Oh, get me a bag. Oh, they're beautiful.
Impossible.
Oh, and the melons. Pick a couple, like three ripe ones.
All right, three ripe.
These are nice.
Kath, come to Janet's party. She really needs people.
Oh, aren't those pretty?
Wonder if I ought to go over to the Dark Horse Tavern and see if any of our old crowd's there. They were always good for a party.
You know what I'm gonna do when we first show a profit? I'm going to buy dozens of beautiful baskets and put all my plants in them.
Yes, and then what will you have to live for? Kath, do you know what happens to people who are all work and no play?
Yeah, they break even.
See this gentleman to 312, please.
So don't worry about not having it.
Oh, no, it's not that. It's that I gotta do my books and,
Are you gonna be a nun all your life?
I need you.
Come on.
Oh, Janet, I can't really. I've gotta make up my calendar. I might even make a profit this month. And I wanna paint the hall. I've been trying to do it tomorrow.
Look, it's just a place to sleep. It's an apartment, not the Taj Mahal.
You mean it's not your Taj Mahal? Anyway, I'm gonna see my mother again tomorrow.
Dance?
I might like that.
Well, isn't that what they're doing in the other room?
That looks like what they're doing.
You gonna take me there?
I think I am.
Hello.
Are you having a good time?
I'll get you a couple.
What's her name?
That's Kathryn Beck.
Oh.
What color?
It's yellow. It's 4 years old, but it drives as good as it did when it was new. It doesn't have any squeaks or squeals. You just put your foot on the pedal and zoom. It's a bright yellow.
See, I'd have guessed blue.
Mm-mm. No, no.
Well, bright yellow is a side of your personality I haven't seen.
Mm.
You're more serious.
What are your true colors?
Well, I'm not too flashy, but I'm never serious. As a rule. You really do like to dance, don't you?
Yeah.
You really float. Touching the ground now. Tell me the truth.
Thinking maybe we could get a ride home.
Sure, are you ready? If you're ready, let's go. We've got a ride.
Get the button planted?
Yeah, I hit it in his coat.
He picked up some girl at the party, and they're on the way out.
Yeah, I see them.
Okay, I'm coming out, too.
We're right out front.
See you in a minute.
I think you had a good time, didn't you, guys? You got it.
Then I hardly saw you.
They're both getting in his car.
Gentle surveillance in progress. Skippy's with us. Sci hangar moving west. West?
Mm-hmm.
Right, west.
Yes, and do you need backup?
That's a negative.
Let's just stay out of sight, everybody.
Can you get anything on the bug?
Can you?
Yeah, they're singing.
Build your heart
so close to mine.
To my eyes.
hotel. I don't know. Maybe he knows her, or maybe he just met her.
Well, let's be sure the hotel's covered.
I couldn't get a feel for it.
I don't know where they're going.
And last, till the end of time.
Just keep going. Go right past him. Let him think he shook us.
I don't like cars crawling on my back. They're following. Who knows? It's hard to trust people.
Okay, then. Go straight ahead and turn left. I live right around the corner. It's the brick house in the middle of the block, 1719.
They just passed us going north. The bug is in his jacket. We'll track him by the bug. They're just around the corner. We've got the address, so stay in range of his radio, and we'll monitor him blind.
DeCarlo, this is Hangar. We're proceeding down 17th. Where do you want us?
Hangar, just get some cover and stay where you are. Everybody, stay out of sight.
Hang on, too.
We're going to stay behind on this block and sit tight. And for Pete's sakes, don't spook him. We don't know how long this party's going to go on. So you guys, stay awake.
I'm not nervous. That just happens. We don't have to rush, do we?
Slow it down. Slow it down.
I picked you out right off, you know.
Don't worry. Once I saw you, you were dead in the water.
Cheese Danish, a quart of hot coffee, and put sugar in separate.
Hey, look, there's...
You just make sure it's black, and lots of it.
There's something I ought to tell you.
And Jack wants some French fries and
coffee. We don't have to say anything about love.
Wait, they're fading. I think she said she doesn't want him to say anything about love.
What?
Thank you.
Wait, I think I hear him again. Yeah, he's up and around. What was that?
He's right on the bug.
Could be putting on his jacket.
All right, everybody, listen up. Everybody on your point.
He's walking around.
He might be getting ready to leave. Now, everybody stay out of sight. Hangar, where are you?
We're on Pine. We're ready.
What was that?
A door.
Is he inside or outside the apartment?
I can't tell. It's muffled. It's breaking up.
He might be moving out. Anybody see anything?
Nothing yet.
What's he doing?
He's walking around. I can't tell where.
Give me a minute.
It's garbage. I can't hear anything.
Hang on. Backside. Anything moving?
Negative. There's nothing moving here.
I'm getting nothing now. It could be dead. He could be out of range.
How could that be? What the hell's going on in there?
I don't know.
What, are you split?
Yeah, he could have split. He could be playing with us. He could be under the bed with the cherry bomb.
Hey, that's it. We're going in. Central, I want state backup and SWAT reinforcement here right away. We're moving in.
County police backup and SWAT has been ordered to Carlo. You are to wait till they arrive.
I want state people, not county.
You'll be covered, DeCarlo. In the meantime, no heroes. No heroes, DeCarlo.
Can't just supersede. Go.
Police!
Oh, oh, I am! Oh, God! What's this for?
Where is he?
Your rope in there?
Yes.
Go get a policeman. Where is he?
I'm alone here. Do police have the right to do this?
All right, search this apartment. Take it apart.
Check the windows. I'll get this one.
I got the spread. You get the sheets. And the other sheet.
Not a hell of a lot here.
Take anything. Anything that will give us a handle on her. We're fishing, so look at everything. And pull anything that could connect her to Cole or the rest of them. We don't know who the hell she is.
Here's a lease. We've been in this apartment 18 months.
Take it.
On what charge?
Witness.
Based on what? An act of sexual congress? We haven't got near enough.
How'd he get out?
I was asleep.
Even then, unless you take her to the hospital, you can't even prove that.
He didn't even say goodbye?
Well?
No.
Did he sleep with you?
Have you got to do that here?
She wasn't answering.
Not a question like that.
How'd he get out of here?
Do I have to answer all his questions? Tell me that list of rights.
That's for suspects. You're a witness. You aren't being arrested at the moment. You're being brought in for interrogation.
This officer here will help you get dressed.
I don't need her.
We do.
I ordered roadblocks on the arterials. If you'd have been a little more open with the city and county, hell, we could have bagged and boxed them.
If.
And as long as she's in our facilities, whether questioning or whatever, we're liable. And I don't take liability without control.
Well, we're cooperating, huh?
And I want all the files on him on my desk by lunch.
Yes.
Find out if Cole's bug is still dead or what.
Here's a letter of recommendation from an attorney named Robert Furman. She worked for him as a cook for 2 years, looks like.
She was divorced 4 years ago.
This might be something.
Who called the press? Who the hell called the press?
Okay, that's all, folks. Everybody go home now. Let's break it up.
I have work. I own a small business. I have a mother sick in the hospital.
Again?
What?
Everything.
Kathryn Beck. My maiden name is Boyers. I just started a small catering business. At Ease Catering.
Talk again about the party.
It was a party. It was at my cousin's house. Why was I kept standing this morning before I was allowed to dress? Why did I have to dress with an open door? I haven't been told anything. I haven't even been able to make a phone call.
I apologize for it. You can walk out. You have that right. If you're opposed to law enforcement or you're guilty of some crime, you should go.
I'd explain it this way, little lady. We can jail you as a material witness with no charges whatsoever. We could haul you to a grand jury, and if you refuse to answer there, they could jail you ad infinitum. So if you have something to hide, go out, find a lawyer, and we'll fight it out. But if you're just an innocent victim of this guy, the way to prove it is to stay here and answer our questions.
A few more, and then we're through.
It's for the best, really.
You said that you met Cole for the first time at the party. Would you affirm that that is your statement?
Yes. Yes. What did he do?
Would you affirm that he spent the night at your apartment?
What did he do? Just what did he do? Yes, he did. He left sometime in the night. I'm not sure when.
And it's your statement that you had no phone.
How did he happen to come to the party? Did he know anybody else there?
Ask somebody else.
Where did he park his car last night?
He parked his car a block away at the Herndon School parking lot.
Social Security, 526-802016. Beck, Kathryn. Motor vehicle violation. Search. 83, none. 82, 2. Non-moving fines paid. 81, 1. Non-moving fines paid.
County Health Licensing Division. Search. Beck, Kathryn. Catering license registration valid through 6186. At Ease Caterers, preparation facilities shared. Inspection certification approved by Department of
City
Health.
City sales tax. Search. First fiscal quarter. $458.73, paid. Second fiscal quarter, not due.
No, that's no good. First of all, look, you can move all this down and make a tight figure, that's one thing. And I don't like either one of these. They're nothing. They're not the hook we're looking for. They're boring. Caton.
William Gaft, chief of police on 5-2,
yeah, put that through right here. Ooh, chief of police. What did I do?
Mr. Caton, this is Bill Gast.
Yeah. Listen, I hope my little article didn't embarrass you, sir.
Absolutely not. Look, the knacks come with the job. And possibly we did get off on the wrong foot when you took over. This PR is not my strong point. So if I was short with you, I apologize. Now listen, that woman we picked up, we think she's in with those radical armored truck robbers. And we could use a little outside heat. She's a good-looking woman. I think it's your kind of story, Mr. Caton. Would a feature on a lady terrorist redress the grievance, so to speak?
If you spend 12 hours with a person in intimate conversation, you must learn some little bit what he does, is, some little bit of information.
No.
You own and drive a car. Why didn't you drive your car to the party?
Well, I thought maybe I'd have too much to drink and I wouldn't want to drive.
Yellow then. Hatchback.
You usually drink a lot?
No, I don't find it that easy to go to parties, and I mean, unless I'm catering it. And so a drink helps me relax.
Or you knew he'd drive you home?
How would I know that? I didn't know he was going to be there. I didn't even think I was going to.
Or you did know him. Did he offer to drive you home, or was it understood that he'd be staying with you?
No, by the time we left, that was understood.
Would you describe your morals as relaxed?
No. I'd like to make that phone call now. I'd like to call Mr. Furman.
You wouldn't call them relaxed?
I'm sorry, Mr. Furman is out of town.
Could you tell me where he is?
He's out of town at a conference. I'll see if I can get you the number.
Run a check on the hatchback. Dismantle whatever you need to while it's on the premises. And if you think we need to break down the chassis or the undercarriage, bring it in and we'll rack it up.
The address is 1719 Michigan Street. I want you to position the surveillance van in the alley next to her building. The phone hookups are shared with the building next door, so you'll connect into the spider box there. You'll need crossover patching for the radio mics inside the apartment.
Yes, ma'am. We're police, and we have a warrant enabling us to search this restaurant and anything having to do with Kathryn Beck's catering.
Kathryn? What about Kathryn?
Very quiet, I'd say. She did have one regular gentleman friend, but he doesn't come around anymore. I hadn't seen him.
Do you know his name?
Oh, no. Has she done something, officer?
Excuse me, ma'am. We'd like to ask you some questions about the people at your party last night.
What? What are you talking about?
Kathryn Beck is your cousin.
Yes.
We'd like to come in and ask you some questions about her. What do you got?
Furman. F-U-H-R-M-A-N.
Very well-connected law firm. Clients are corporations, politicians.
I tried to reach him by phone. He's out of town. I did get a hold of the restaurant guy, and I have an appointment with him. She has an account at CI Savings, and her original application lists Furman as an employer.
All right, get me his out-of-town number. I want to speak with him right away and get something in before deadline. Art, find me her ex-husband. Those eyes. Great shot. Run it on one. First edition.
You arrived at about 7:45. Several others arrived before he did. And you talked with only one man besides Cole, and you stopped talking with him when he became amorous.
I won't agree to that. I said he made advances.
How's that different?
You said amorous.
Same thing.
It's not the same thing. It means something else. It means that I was, that like it was a two-way thing or flirting. I wasn't. He was simply making advances.
But when Cole walks in, it's magic. You see a stranger across a crowded room. Crap! We've been taking statements from people in your building. We know you see men on a regular basis. Well, that's your business unless you're selling, and we'll find out about that. But we don't care who you're giving it to. You can transmit some things that way, but not criminal guilt. The only thing we want from you is the truth. Now let's get this wrapped up.
Forget amorous making advances, okay?
I didn't say Cole. I said Ben. I wouldn't say Cole. I won't agree to that.
Just finish this. You sign it and you can go home. Now, you say that you only danced with Cole, with Ben, all evening, and the party was relaxed, and you spent most, if not all, of your time...
Now, we really watched that building! I want to know how you helped him get away. We're going to find out the truth about that, too.
Spent most, if not all, he seemed very cheerful. He wasn't nervous, that you could see.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Furman.
Yes? Who is this?
This is Donald Caton from the Ledger Citizen.
Yes, Mr. Caton, I know who you are.
Who?
I'm inquiring about a former employee of yours, a Miss Kathryn Beck. I'm gathering information for a story.
Kathryn?
There was a message she called. The red light was on.
She says that she was employed by you and your wife as a domestic when she moved here from Petersburg.
What kind of story, sir?
Is that, well, and she also states that she left your employ 2 years ago.
What is the story?
Let me just ask this. Do you think that she would be capable of some serious crime? I mean, is she emotional enough, or does she have such radical politics, perhaps, that she...
You won't find a more cool, level-headed lady. What is the story?
Did she ever express political views to you, sir? Mr. Furman? Hello, Mr. Furman?
Listen, we may have to go back tomorrow morning. Skip the rest.
I want you to do a file on the Furmans, husband and wife.
This is good background. It might even turn out to be foreground. I mean, why is he going to hang up on me unless he's got something to hide? Build up the file.
That's easy enough.
Well, if it's easy enough, you're not doing enough.
Please, don't be upset. Your apartment's kind of messed up. I'm sorry about it, but...
Got an ugly one.
Rivoli Hotel. Mr. Robert Furman, please. Just a moment. I'm sorry, Mr. Furman checked out a short while ago. Oh, thanks.
Tomorrow's high in the upper 60s, lower in the lake area. Topping local news this evening, Ben Cole, a suspect in last month's armored truck robbery, eluded police today in a dramatic escape from the apartment of his girlfriend, Kathryn Beck. Miss Beck, a local caterer, was taken in for questioning in regard to Cole's whereabouts and the workings of the radical underground. More news and the day in sports after this.
If you're shopping for a loan, whether it's for home improvement, a new car, or
Hello?
Hello? Oh.
I'm sorry to wake you.
Oh, no. Don't be. Never be that.
I won't.
I was thinking, were you all right?
I have to tell you that the police were after you. They rushed in here today. They were god-awful. They used handcuffs and everything.
They took me down and asked me a whole lot of questions.
Stop talking.
About you all day.
Shh. You all right? I'm so sorry about it, Kathryn.
Ben? What did you do?
Not on the phone. That's not make it easy for him. Talk to me.
You're like a beautiful boy when you sleep.
When did I sleep?
I was dreaming about being awake. You don't know what you did.
Tell me.
Like hell I will.
You're a sweet woman.
We'll have to have short conversations, comprendo?
I'll call you.
Did you get it?
No, it was too short.
How much?
I could only trace the first two numbers.
Mailbox.
What?
You just see the newspaper?
I saw it. You want some coffee? It's all
I
made.
I just ran out of there. You should see what they did to everything. And my beautiful car.
I'll throw this out.
No, I'm saving it. I'm saving everything. Did you see these? What did you say? Yeah, coffee. I'd like some coffee. Somebody's gonna show these to my mother. And she'll believe it, too. People are gonna believe this. I've gotta call Bob Furman. They've tapped my phone.
Oh, Mr. Furman, please.
Kathryn Beck.
Well, do you know when he'll be there?
Well, this is an emergency. Well, would you give him this number when he gets in? It's, 555-7203. Thanks. Oh, God. Oh, God.
If you told me she was showing her bare fanny from the top of the Capitol building, there would be no surprise in it at all for me. However, she just might be sorry now. Yeah, I bet you she is sorry now.
For what?
I have the dairy now. I didn't have it then.
What do you mean, the money?
This wasn't mine then. It was my dad's. I was just a worker, and you know women. She'd kiss me now.
She left you?
Well, because I wouldn't jump to her tune. The real fact was I didn't care. Either she wanted to be my wife or she didn't. The sense of it was, no, I wouldn't throw her out, but I wouldn't dance to her tune. So she was always in the soul. She was a bitch. She didn't have a daddy to lay down the law. He died when she was a kid. And her mother is one, too, and an alcoholic.
Well, tell me this. Was Kathryn ever in trouble with the police?
Well, she's married to me. So what do you want to know
about? Well, where's her mother now?
Oh, her mother's always in and out of the hospital.
I don't know what he did. I mean, if the papers say he robbed a bank, does that mean he did? Or a terrorist? 2 days ago, I believe the papers.
He didn't admit it?
He said the people were... they were hounding him. People or police, people, I don't know. I don't know what he did. And they're asking so many questions, I don't think they know.
You helped him get away?
During the night, I got out of bed, and I went in the kitchen. And he woke up and called me. I heard his voice call my name. And my heart jumped. I mean, just his voice. And then it was calling me. Whatever he did, it can't be terrible. He's so gentle. And he made me feel that I could trust. What is that?
Oh, brother.
It's new to me. I didn't expect it. Do you know what I'm saying?
Interesting guy for her to have married.
He'd make a terrorist out of me.
But that's not the hook I'm looking for. I can't wait to interview her mother.
The guy said the old lady's a lush. Man, you sure lucked out on this story.
It's about time for a break, isn't it?
You've only been here 3 months.
I'm gonna wake up this country, bring some life in.
Well, you sure doing that.
Graceful. Diamonds are small, but that hardly matters when there are so many and they're so clear. And that ruby, it's a beauty, obviously Burmese.
How much?
Too much for a woman who lives on a caterer's salary.
Think she's got a boyfriend she's keeping quiet about?
If she does, he's a rich one. Let's tell DiCarlo about it and let's bring her back in.
I'm here.
Sit, please. Tell us about some of your other friends.
What do you mean about my friends?
Start with the men, the ones you have relations with, lovers.
I'm not going to answer a question like that. And you know, with Ben, whatever you say he might have done, I wouldn't believe you. All of your hands are dirty. You don't give a damn. You went into my apartment and trashed my apartment. That's my home. You tore up my car. On what right? What did I do? Who in the hell do you think you are?
Who gave you the ring?
What ring?
Show her it.
That's mine. You took it, you stole it. Nobody gave it to me, I bought it. Can I have it back, please?
It's on an inventory, you'll get it back in time. Where did you buy it?
It's hard to remember.
Very expensive?
No.
You say no, but it is. Who gave it to you?
I already answered that. It's his costume.
Yeah. Well, you think about it again. And, here. We want to talk about the car, too. Write down every trip you made out of town in the last month and who you might have visited. And if you have any doubt about our right to ask, I can sort you away as a material witness. We'll boot you up to a grand jury, and if you don't answer there, we'll jail you until you do. Now, if you decide to keep quiet for the rest of your life, you could stay in jail for the rest of your life. Concentrate on the men.
Sorry, sir. Mrs. Boyer's not able to have visitors. Well, she's in a special care unit. Only immediate family, and I just have one name.
You mean a daughter, Kathryn?
Yes, sir.
Well, what exactly is wrong with Mrs. Boyer's? Can you tell me that?
Her doctor's Dr. Samuels.
Nothing to worry about. Everything's fine. Don't need to move. Mrs. Boyers? I think we have enough light, don't you? Yeah, sure. We'll push it. Well, we'll just push it. Now, this is just for the record. Nothing to worry about. It's not important. Don't worry. Okay, how you feeling today, Mrs. B, huh?
Are you a resident?
Well, in a way, I guess you could say that, sort of, yeah. Your daughter has not been by to see you lately, has she?
Oh, no. She was supposed to.
Oh, that's sad. Mm-hmm. Well, did you, I don't suppose you saw this, did you see this paper? No, I don't say she's been arrested. It's, her picture is, did she ever mention a coal? Take it easy now, take it easy. Coal, did she ever? No, she has not been arrested. Ben.
What do you want to hear?
Is she all right? Can she hear what I'm saying?
You're not supposed to be in this room.
Well, I thought I heard.
Get out now.
Right,
you don't belong anywhere on this floor.
For you, a circle of love, C. What do you think it means?
I don't know. Where'd you find it?
It was loose.
No antelope?
Uh-uh. Hmm.
Hand me the ring box.
The ring? She's claiming she bought the ring for herself.
Oh, yeah? Did she write herself the note, too? She's got a secret. They're much easier to break when they've got a secret.
All right, tell DiCarlo.
I don't know. Maybe it came with it.
It says circle of love. Wouldn't that be a ring?
I don't know. Circle of love? It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't say ring. I don't know who wrote it. I don't recognize the handwriting.
Your friend, Mr. Cole?
I've had that ring a long time. I met him two nights ago.
Did you?
Look, I told you, please. I bought it at a flea market. And it was just a couple of dollars. I think it was just a real lucky bargain.
Wouldn't a man give a ring to a woman that in the middle of the night he calls his? What did you think this was? We're in the middle of a major investigation. Everything you say is held alongside plenty of information we already have. No, I feel absolutely no embarrassment hunting down some slick, cocky son of a bitch we have every good reason to believe is a radical extremist. Bombs, murders, the whole thing. And no embarrassment about coming down hard on you for protecting him because he may be God's gift to women in bed. We know that you helped him escape. And why would you? For a one-night stand? Crap. We know about this ring. That's another gentleman in your life. Hmm? Love this one. Do it with that one. Think it through, lady. Right now, hon, I have other people to talk to. Consider yourself a material witness. I'll give you a place to sit and think. If you're not with us, you're a Guinness.
I'm Bob Furman, representing Kathryn Beck. I believe she's here for interrogation.
Kathryn Beck's attorney's out front.
Furman is your friend. You can stall him. Tell him that this is a big state investigation, that she came down here voluntarily.
What the hell do you boys do for brains?
Bob, don't prejudge.
Where's Kathryn?
She's here for good cause.
If she isn't charged, produce her. I read that story. You know her.
Met her, yes. Are you so certain you know her? In any event, this is a very heavy state investigation.
This is City PD. Charger or producer?
You're reading the very worst of them. Now, the other two barely say anything at all. No pictures, one doesn't mention your name. Now, I don't know how the ledger gets its information. None of us spoke to any of the press at all.
Well, she stopped talking to us yesterday, but she came back in voluntarily today. Anyway, the state is conducting this.
I don't want to hear about the state. There's no paper on her, city or state. Not a new tactic. I know the woman to be honest, industrious, shy. I say to myself when I read what's printed, they're leaking lies to the press to try and squeeze something out of her, which she may have or she may not. You dress like bankers, go to concerts, and your tactics are slime. Come on, get legal. Charger or producer?
She'll be out here in 15 minutes. Did you ever hear of Arthur Ebersol? Arthur Ebersol. Diane Kestenmeyer. Have you ever heard the name Kevin Peen? P-E-E-N.
Who might she know in DeKalb?
Yes, you know anyone living in the DeKalb vicinity?
Miss Beck, I had to think you'd want to help us all you can. You can't say you haven't been well treated.
I don't say anything now without Mr. Furman.
Just need a couple more hours. Just a little while longer, maybe 3 to 4 hours. You're dreaming. Her lawyer's in the lobby. There's no way we can hold her any longer.
I don't give a damn about her. I'm after him. I'm after him.
Let me have some time with her first. Let's talk.
Okay. Tell me first.
Ask me.
Did you say that I was the kind of person who'd get ahead any way that I can?
You know me better than that.
I want to know what you said.
I don't know. Cool and level-headed, maybe. Something like that. He wrote that I said you were cold
and calculating.
And I didn't. I wouldn't. I'm here. I'm going to help you. Would I do otherwise?
Did you say that I was a criminal?
No. I'm going to threaten the ledger citizen with a liable action. It won't stop them. It might slow them down. What's the truth?
I met him at Janet's party. He spent the night with me. I don't know what he did. He said that people were following him. I helped him sneak away. Janet knows.
All right, have you admitted that?
No. I think they know. They're listening in.
Listen, they're going to keep on squeezing you as long as they believe you know where he is.
How long can they keep holding me down here?
Forever. You're in the ridiculous position of having almost no rights at all. At least none would help.
Now, do you think that she's with the weatherman?
Unknown. But we're going to have a few surprises. The pressure's telling. She'll crack soon. You don't have to name sources. Just don't forget the county attorney's office. The bigger papers seem to be hanging back.
Well, that's because they can afford to. We're still growing.
Yes. What number are you calling? Who are you calling? Would you please identify yourself? You please?
No, no. Just leave it. Look, see? Come back.
Does not bother me, Mrs. Furman. I wish it did.
Difficult to tell you, Mister, the degree of contempt I hold you in.
Lives are affected by the cruelty of your particular brand of lying. I mean, there must be decent people in your line of work. It can't be necessary.
Listen. I'm working on a story for tomorrow's issue, and I would really appreciate it if these crank calls were a little more concise. You know what I mean?
Take your little poison typewriter, no doubt rusted by your poison little mind, and unlubricated by any salve of conscience or good purpose, Mister Caton. Deliver it as deeply as possible.
Thank you. Nice to talk to you.
It's the worst kind of journalism. Our papers played it absolutely straight, although that kind of nonsense pushes us. The Ledger's a sinking operation, excessive.
Well, isn't that worth a story? That they're ruining this woman's reputation with lies?
We can't. We can't. You're right, but we can't be put in the position of pointing the finger at another paper.
They don't have that in the papers. I'll take sugar.
It's Bunny's.
Honey, can it be? Why put yourself through it?
When we visited Mrs. Boyers, a broken woman now terminally ill in Petersburg Community Hospital, it was clear that her daughter's bad fortune was a devastating blow. Speaking in monosyllables, pain written on her face, she conveyed to this reporter a sense of having failed to inculcate adequate moral standards in her child. No one, not even her mother, seemed willing to defend Kathryn Beck.
Miss Beck, they tried to reach you all last night.
When did she die?
I wasn't on shift. I'm sorry. Would you go down to the office? You have to do that whole thing on top of it.
Yes.
What was the reporter doing here?
He snuck in yesterday. I threw him out. I read what he wrote. Your mother was comatose. She couldn't have said any of that. What a shame. It's hard enough.
Thank you.
are not set up to handle this gracefully. There's paperwork, and then you can make your own arrangements, and then we can release the body to your representative.
How are you doing?
This isn't a diary, it's an appointment book.
Well, I've got something. We traced that ring. It was purchased a year ago last May at Cartier's for $7,800 by a big city contractor named Karl Macaluso. And guess what? His lawyer's Bob Berman.
Karl Macaluso's here. He's been waiting.
Karl, I'm sorry. It's been a difficult time, but I'm finally here. I resent having to chase you. I've been trying to get to you since yesterday morning.
Well, you have my full attention now.
Well, it's not business related. It's personal. It's somewhat important. Very.
Is this the nature of a confession?
I figured you knew.
How long have you been sleeping with her?
I love her. You're taking care of her, and I'll pay whatever cost she has.
Corey saw it happening. She said she saw you descending. Claws akimbo was the way she put it. Give her gifts?
Gifts, a ring, the key to my summer house in Alton.
Is this Charlotte aware?
God, no. She's blind.
Carl, it's a mistake to underrate everybody. If Corey saw it, Charlotte is certainly aware.
I gotta be left out of this. I talked to the police. Volunteered. Gave a small interview in my office. They were very nice. I explained what little I could. They wouldn't make any promises, but now I'm going to stay out of it. I told them, I made my point. Now, what scares me more than anything is the newspapers. Now, I'll lose the Civic Center renewal if my name pops out.
Are you still sleeping with her?
She's... No. No, not any longer. She has this, I'm scared for it, too. Did I say I'd pay? Why are you so angry about it? Come on, I told you I love her. Then there's the matter of the key to my house in Alton. I'd like to get it back.
Ben?
Mm-hmm.
My mother's...
Blood on cover. Must have picked up on the tap. There's no talking, really. They hung up on us.
Hung up on us?
They must have heard us tap in. So what's the plan?
We got to begin. Let's call for a confirmation and go. We're not going to get any more from him, and the longer we wait, the more time he's got to get ready for us.
Sounds like we're through.
Yep, we spooked him.
Well, I think it's time we picked up the pot and ran.
It's all yours.
That's what I'm going to do.
Confirm, 10-4.
or keep on moping, shall we dance and walk on air? Shall we save him to despair, or shall we dance with never a care? Life is short, we're growing older, don't you see? And also right.
You feel guilty, that's all, because they met at your house. He's a rich client, she was your cook. He probably made her a lot of promises and broke them all. It's a shame. But now Macaluso needs protection. It's part of our job. It's too bad. That's what he pays us for. We have to keep him out of the papers. You use your contacts down at the prosecutor's office. Pass the word that Macaluso's name stays out. Tell him they don't have to talk about his love life. And let's hope that this is all there is.
I'm also privately representing Kathryn Beck.
You represent Macaluso first. How much money does she account for each year?
Yes, little gal.
Switchboard's been trying to reach you. This here's Kathryn Beck.
Are you on hold? Mm-hmm. You get your recording equipment quick like a bunny.
Yes, this is Donald Caton.
My mother's dead. Isn't that a great story for you?
Well, now, I'm very sorry, Shirley, and I'm saddened. Would you hold on for just 1 minute? Check the Petersburg Community Hospital about her mother. She says she's dead. Go on. Well, now, how are you, Miss Beck?
Are you done with me yet?
I don't know. Would you like to tell your side? You certainly may.
I want to.
All right, well, now, where are you? I can come and see you, or you can come here if you'd like.
My apartment.
Sure thing. Now?
Tomorrow, say 12.
All right. I look forward to this. Now, may I bring my photographer?
You have pictures.
I really am very sorry about your mother, but she was very sick after all, wasn't she?
People don't have no understanding of it. They gliss right through life. Do you know gliss? I bet you don't know. I used to play the trombone. The gliss is the slide on the slide.
Oh, Kat. I'm not staying.
Friend.
I just came by. They haven't made any trouble for you.
No, just questions. But there's been a lot of cancellations. Mrs. Reinauer called about the party tomorrow night. She's had to cancel, too.
Oh, Kat. Ooh, wait, just a sec.
Police. Did I tell you about my trouble with those bastards? They go through garbage.
Cap, are you all right?
I'm all right.
Hey, Mary, better turn down the flame in here.
She's home.
Standing there, not moving. These new electric babies pick up nose hairs, waving in the wind.
Can you hear skin crawl?
I'll bet her skin don't crawl. Hmm. I'll bet it slides like a wet chamois. Doing some job. Putting, picking things up off the floor. Very meticulous. I can't have silk, you know. I can tell you silk from cotton. Another one of those calls.
Yeah, I don't want to hear it.
Great imagination, no dialogue. She's not talking. That voice gets me.
In Illinois today, a state and Madison County police raid netted the capture of Ben Cole, a suspected co-conspirator in last month's armored truck robbery. The break-in took place this afternoon at the summer home of prominent businessman Karl Macaluso. Police believe that Cole may be connected to a radical underground movement financing its organization with armored truck and bank robberies. Police discovered Cole's whereabouts when a neighbor who knew the house was vacant noticed a light on in the evenings. Local police spotted Cole's car and recognized the license plate. Mr. and Mrs. Macaluso were informed of the episode by phone, and when asked if he intended to press charges against Cole, Macaluso declined to comment.
Sir, she is not moving around. The phone is off the hook. Absolutely not moving.
I'm not interested. Get out of there. Our job is done.
Why is that?
They've got Ben Cole. Surveillance is over. Now move.
Sir, I cannot go in and disable anything and remove anything while she's there.
Are you listening or arguing?
Yes, sir.
You're arguing?
No, sir, I'm not arguing. All I'm saying, if she weren't...
Then put the damn equipment there and get out.
Yes, sir.
You and Mel will return to get the equipment when the department tells you it's time. You'll leave now.
And I will return with Mel when the department calls the guard. Yes, sir.
I see weathermen on television.
Would you call Kevin Peen a radical?
I wouldn't call anybody anything. They might call me something.
I want to take these one by one.
Except him. I'd call him if he's the one I think he is, a weird piece of work.
Loads of laughter.
When he put the cuffs on me, I asked myself, this guy washes hands.
Arthur Ebersole.
Then when he hit me in the mouth, I really got worried. I told you guys, give me an attorney.
Kathryn Beck.
Who?
Maybe you'd like to say something about her connection with the armored car thing. Whether she's in the same political group as...
Nice lady. We both met her at the party. You remember. I don't know her politics. You don't know my politics. I don't know any armored car thing. The lady's just a case of hit and run. Come on. I know you've been chasing me, but it escapes me what for.
For openers? Breaking and entering.
What breaking and entering?
You were in a private home, trespassing.
Mister, I got the key in my pocket. The real key right here in my pocket. The real key.
The Ledger Citizen, in its ongoing investigation, has discovered that Robert Furman, Beck's attorney, a member of the prestigious law firm of Lanier Kemp, has been connected to the same radical groups, such as the violent Weather Underground. Here we go, your ACLU cases.
Still busy. She must still have the phone off the hook.
Boy, this creep never stops. What will happen to Kathryn Beck now that her lover is captured, her mother is dead, and her business is failing?
If she doesn't answer soon, I'm going over there.
Her childhood with an alcoholic mother, her early marriage to a simple dairy farmer, her affair with extremist Ben Cole will be explored by this newspaper.
You'll have to wait outside until she decides to let you shoot. Right now, she's got the jumps. Let's be early, huh?
Yeah.
you deserve a better picture. You're really a lovely gal. Pretty little dress. I can see why the...
Oh. I get sickening calls now.
Well, people... Can I just sit anywhere? I really was sorry to hear about your mother, but I guess that was to be expected. And now, whatever people may say about me, I am always willing to listen and I'm always willing to learn. My job is to be tough, but I am as nice a guy as you're ever going to meet. Now, I'm going to want to take some notes here. I hope that doesn't inhibit you, huh?
I think you killed her. I think you killed two of us.
No, no, sweetie, no. Have you heard from him since they picked him up?
No.
Mm-hmm. Do you know where they're holding him?
No.
Well, I can be some help in that. I have some placed friends, as I find out now you do too.
Why do you print lies? Is it any easier than printing the truth?
I suppose you have a special corner on that commodity, huh? I think we do pretty well. Look, there is no such thing as objective journalism. Everyone is a human being, and every human being may have a bias, but not a malice. Now, I have no malice toward you. I do have some facts, and I am entitled to interpret them. That is what I sell. I see you sitting there, and I say to myself, she's selling something, too. You're selling something, aren't you? Pretty little dress.
I married her right out of high school. I didn't know anything. It was a bad thing that I married him. The boy I wanted to marry, and who asked me to marry him, he was killed in the army. My father died when I was 11.
Mm.
And my mother and I just never saw things the same way. So when Herb asked me, I did. He had a problem drinking. He'd get mean and go after me, no matter what he said.
Mm-hmm.
I shouldn't have married him. But it's not like you said. Or like he said. I worked ever since.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to print any of this, are you?
No, I'm taking notes.
Not a one.
Right here.
Not a one. Are you going to print any of this?
Why don't you tell me something worth printing? Were you ever involved in radical politics? Did Cole tell you where he hid the money? What, and this is just for my own curious interest, what have you got going with this big city VIP? You do something special in bed? That, of course, I wouldn't print that, but I just don't get holy with me. Just say whatever's on your mind. What did he tell you about the robbery while he was making the beast? Come on, just tell me everything. You don't have to worry. Now that he has been arrested, we're not going to be focusing on you, but I can keep it alive. I can make it all better. I really can. You should not underestimate the value of notoriety. And don't worry about the notes. I got it all. Are you afraid of me? There's no need. There's no need. You know, the cops took me through here that one morning after you just got picked up, but I didn't get a chance to see how nice it is. They were all over everything.
Thank you. You're the daughter?
Yes. Thank you for coming.
I read about you. Nothing is sacred in those papers. I knew Nancy from the railroad station when she worked there. I'm a Nancy, too. Oh. Nancy Skelly. She was always so proud of you. She told me you have your own food business there and all. Mm-hmm. Not many knew her. The center gives you a dry meal. At the railroad station, interesting people all the time. I know you were good to her.
Thank you. You'll sign the book?
I will.
Oh, good. It's right in there.
She was a hard worker.
Yes, I know.
Thank you.